Hi there. Today, we're going to be talking about ratio basics. And as a result of this lesson, students are going to be able to learn what ratios are, learn the three different ways to write ratios, and learn how to correctly read ratios. Coming up on the Math Review. So first of all, what exactly are ratios? Well, ratios are comparisons of two numbers. And the order of these two numbers is really important. And there are three ways to write these ratios. The first way to write ratios is by using the word two. The second way to write ratios is by using fraction notation. And the third way to write ratios is by using a colon. And don't let that word fool you, a colon is just these two dots, one on top of the other. Now, with math, it's a lot easier to learn from examples. So let's go over our first one. Let's say we have all of these shapes, and I want to know the ratio of circles to stars. One other important thing to remember is that these things you're talking about are called terms. This is our first term. In other words, this is the first thing we're talking about in our ratio, and this here is our second thing that we're talking about in our ratio, also called the second term. Since we're talking about the ratio of circles to stars, we want to make sure that we talk about the number of circles first, and then we talk about the number of stars second. Let's rearrange these so that it's a little bit easier to see. So now we've got our circles on this side and our stars on this side. Well, how many circles do you see? I see 1, 2. So that's going to be the first number in our ratio. Then we'll write the word 2, and then we'll talk about the number of stars. And how many stars do you see? I see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So since we have 5 stars, that'll be the second number in our ratio. So we'll say the ratio of circles to stars is 2 to 5. And remember, there's two other ways to write this. We've already used the word 2, now we can use the fraction form, and that would be 2 over 5. And finally, we'll use the colon, which again are just these two dots. So we would write 2 colon 5. But here's the really important thing to remember. Even though you write ratios in three different ways, you only read it in one. And that way to read it is the ratio of circles to stars is 2 to 5. Let's take a look at our next example. This time, we're talking about the ratio of stars to circles. Our first term here is the number of stars. The second thing we're talking about, or the second term, is our number of circles. Again, let's rearrange these shapes so that it's easier to see. How many stars do you see? Well, I see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So since we're talking about stars and there's 5 of them, that'll be the first number in our ratio. Then we'll write the word 2, and then we'll talk about our second term, which is the number of circles. Well, that would be 1, 2. So I'll write a 2 as the second term of my ratio. And since we're talking about the ratio of stars to circles, we would say the ratio of stars to circles is 5 to 2. But don't forget, there's two other ways to write this. One is as a fraction, and that would be 5 over 2. And the other is using the colon, which is just those two dots. And we would write 5 colon 2. But even though there's three ways to write it, there's only one way to read it, and that would be to read it as The ratio of stars to circles is 5 to 2. Let's go over our last example. Here, we're talking about the ratio of blue squares to orange squares. Let's rearrange the squares so that it's a little bit easier to see. So what do you think the ratio of blue squares to orange squares is? If you were guessing 7 to 3, you'd be absolutely right. Some students might look at this problem and say, well, hey, couldn't the ratio just be 3 to 7? No, sorry, that would be wrong, because order matters in ratios. Since we're talking about the number of blue squares first, the number of blue squares, the first number that we write, and the number of orange squares will be the second number that we write. And let's go over why that's the answer. The number of blue squares is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And that'll be the first number in our ratio. Then we'll write in the word 2. And then we'll write in the number of orange squares, which is 1, 2, 3. So we'll put that right after the word 2. The second way to write it is as a fraction, and we'll write 7 over 3. And finally, we'll write it using a colon as 7 colon 3. And even though there's three ways to write the ratio, there's only one way to read it. And that would be, the ratio of blue squares to orange squares is 7 to 3.